the Philippine government and the National Democratic Front agreed to stop offensive operations between government troops and the Communist New People's Army as military and police battle local terrorists in Marawi City. President Rodrigo Duterte on Saturday said he is considering absorbing qualified members of the NPA into the military. The fifth round of talks between the government and the communists was earlier cancelled after the CPP ordered forces on the ground to accelerate and intensify attacks against the government after Duterte's proclamation of martial law in Mindanao. Duterte proclaimed martial law after the Abu Sayyaf and Mauke groups attempted to take over Marawi City on May 23. The president also suspended the privilege of the writ of habeas corpus. The Office of the Ombudsman dismisses a treason and espionage complaint against former President Benigno Aquino and Senator Antonio Trillanes. The complaint was filed in May 2016 after it was revealed Aquino tapped Trillanes for back-channel negotiations with Chinese representatives over Scarborough Shoal. The resolution was signed on February 24 but received only by Trillanes on June 7. It says there was no probable cause for treason or espionage. Ombudsman Conchita Carpio Morales says China's aggressive posturing was known as early as May 2011, but the back-channel negotiation between Senator Trillanes and China only began in May 2012. The resolution says, quote, "The alleged hostilities and aggression in the West Philippine Sea could not, therefore, be attributed to the back-channel discussions between Senator Trillanes and the Chinese representatives." Morales says treason is a war crime and not an all-time offense. The ombudsman adds back-channel talks cannot be considered giving aid to the enemy. Trillanes' role in the situation was first revealed by former Senator Juan Ponce Enrile. But the ombudsman says the documents which Enrile based his allegations on were hearsay and should not be given evidentiary weight. At least one is killed while several people are injured after a vehicle hit pedestrians in North London Monday. Muslim leaders say worshippers leaving Finsbury Park Mosque are among those injured. London police arrest one suspect. Finsbury Park Mosque was once a notorious hub for radical Islamists, but has entirely changed in recent years under new management. The mosque reported it received threatening emails and letters in the wake of the Paris attacks. Its former Imam Abu Hamza was jailed for life in New York on terrorism charges in 2015. He preached there from 1997 to 2003 before being jailed for inciting violence.